Today we're shooting a roll of Kodak T-Max 400 film, which is a black and white film, which as you might know, I am absolutely not used to. I'm very used to shooting color. So this is quite different, but I take on the challenge. I actually didn't buy this roll myself because I was motivated to shoot black and white, but it's actually an assignment from college. I'm in this class called documentary photography, but part of this documentary photography class is also analog photography. And so the last few weeks, our professor showed us how to develop black and white film and also how to print black and white film in the darkroom. And then after those classes, he gave us a second roll of black and white film, which we are now supposed to shoot. And then in about 5 days or so, I think, is the next class. When we were back in the darkroom, we're going to develop this roll of film again and see if there's any print-worthy shots. If not, I'll just print some more from the last roll because there were quite a few cool photos there. Here are some. And so yeah, let's go out and get some more shots and see if any print-worthy photos come out on this roll. So I just arrived at location and it's gonna be interesting because I was just scouting on Google Maps and found two lakes, which didn't seem like lakes that were thought for guests. One was called a Bagger Lake, and I just found this here. So I don't exactly know where I am and what I'm about to find, but I think one lake's over there and one lake's here, and I'm right in between at the moment. And then we're just gonna check out the neighborhood here because as I came here, it looked quite cute here. So yeah, let's see what kind of shots we can get. And I think I'm just gonna start straight off with this thing because it's random and cool. I don't like that lad there. It's a little annoying. So here's the first shot of the session. As you can see, I unfortunately didn't manage to get the van out of the photograph. I actually thought I had it out of frame, but seems like I saw something incorrectly. Nevertheless, I think it's a good start. I enjoyed the scene as a whole. After that, I got closer to the vehicle thinking of possibly finding some details to shoot. However, I found something else instead.
What is this? Why is this here? Oh god, where have I come here? Ooh. Is this worth a photo? I don't know. Oh, with the container, it could be quite cool actually.
Here's the photograph, I really like it. It feels quite documentary style, and I just find the subject matter overall rather intriguing.
So is there any way to get through here? I am definitely not equipped with the right shoes. I'll find another way to get in there, never mind. Let's check it out later.
So I went around the corner and found a road going towards the lake, or at least where I thought the lake was going to be.
This feeling that the lake we're looking for is back there along this rusty whatever this is.
As I walked back, that rusty pipeline or what that is caught my eye again, and I found that it gave this field the perfect touch for an interesting composition. I tried to get a shot and got this, which I think is a beautiful outcome. And the line is a perfect leading line right down the photograph into the center. I also enjoyed the branches around the middle framing this scene.
I'm so curious what there is down there, but I'm not sure if somebody's gonna come out and scold me. Or maybe I can go there. I'm feeling very watched by these houses. Oh wow.
This is the photo I got, and I'm really fond of it.
There's a lot going on, but it still doesn't feel cluttered to me. The fence in the foreground adds this nice subframe, and I'm enjoying the separation in layers here with the midground in front of us and the lake in the background.
I think I'm definitely not the kind of guy to do urban exploring. I feel so wrong being here.
Next, I was walking along the side of this field here, and I liked the lines in the earth, so I got this shot. I like the outcome, however, I do find this photo to be a bit boring. The lines are cool, but that's pretty much it. Maybe a subject in the sky would have been good. I continued to the end of the field and came to this hut, behind which I could see there might be a way to get to that lake. There wasn't an actual path, but it was clear that many people have walked this way before, so I just followed along and eventually found some steps which go right down to the water where I found this thing. This photo turned out pretty nicely, I think. This machine just adds so much interest to the scene. Then, I decided to switch my lens to the 60-300mm telephoto lens to get a close shot of the machine that is further in the lake. The photograph turned out quite okay. This one is busy and slightly cluttered. I do like the framing with the branches though, but they also seem to clutter the photo, or maybe it's something else. And one thing I do not enjoy is that I completely missed the straightness of the photo. After that, I made my way out of this little forest and came out to this field. I was feeling very uncomfortable walking here because I wasn't sure if I was allowed to be here, and unlike the forest, this field had houses which I needed to pass, so I could easily be approached by someone here. Therefore, I was nervously walking to the other side, aiming to get back to the road. However, instead of the road, I found this.
Uh-oh. I think I'm lost. I thought this was a road here, not a river. Oops.
I followed the river and came to a farmhouse. I could hear people chatting, and so I wanted to somehow just sneak past them to avoid an awkward explanation. To look less suspicious, just in case they did see me, I took off the GoPro.
I think I'm out.
So yeah, I made it out and came to this shed, which caught my attention. I got a simple straight shot of it, which I think turned out pretty decent. I like the small details of the shed. There are many things to look at here, which is what it makes the photo, I think, seeing as the composition isn't anything special. Then I continued down this road, and just a bit further I found this cute river. I'm really happy about this photo. I think it's a cute scene with the sheds to the side. I like it.
Hello.
A couple roads onward, I walked past this garden which caught my attention because I found it so cute. It had this cool water pump and just overall a neat vibe which I wanted to capture. This is the outcome. I like it. This is another one of those photos which don't particularly shine with the composition or lighting. Instead, it's simply an interesting scene in my eyes. I enjoy looking at this garden and the various features of it. A bit further, I found yet another cute garden. The photo I got is okay, I think. The garden's cuteness comes across, I find, but everything is just grey. I mean, of course, that's the nature of black and white film, but what I mean to express is that this scene lacks some contrast. I imagine this would have looked better on a sunny day. Then, close to that garden, I came to the other lake I was talking about. Turned out that this lake is a part of a quarry, hence the name, Bagger Lake, I guess. The stone hills at the back looked pretty interesting, and I saw two guys sitting on top of one, so I took the chance to get a photo of them. Here's the photo, and I love it. It's this wide, spacey scene, and the two people make the perfect small subject for scale. Next, I approached the lake and came to these people here, which looked like the perfect opportunity to get a shot of them as the subject with the lake. This is what I got. I think it works. The composition is simple, yet effective, and I love the clear subjects here and the sense of scale they add to the photo. I continued along the side of the lake and came to these rock hills. I like the photo, but I imagine this could be so much better with a person in the midst of the scene to provide a sense of scale and a point of contrast. Next, I turned to the two men here and got a shot of them enjoying their Saturday afternoon at the lake. I love this one. It feels peaceful and in a way romantic, like a memory. How cool was that? I wasn't expecting that I was going to be able to get to this lake, seeing as the other lake was so protected. But I have to say, this lake was far more impressive than the other one because this one had these huge sand mountains and rocks and stuff. Here are two photos I got of this place, one of the plant and one self-portrait in the window's reflection. Shortly after that, the GoPro's battery died, but fortunately I had the Sony with me and could record the rest with it. I had come to this logistics center of a wood company. I wanted to get a photo of this because I was impressed by the size of everything. I felt tiny. Sadly, the size doesn't seem to come across so much. I guess I would have needed a subject. I explored the area a little more and found these steps, which I believed could make for an interesting subject. The photograph turned out nicely. The scene has a lot to look at, however, I do think it could need a clearer subject. Then, to the right of the stairs, I walked up to the fence to point the camera through it and capture the area behind. This again is an okay photo of the space, but it misses a subject for the viewer to focus on. Next, I turned around to the other side of the road where I found this building. I like the photo, it feels empty in a good way, but again, I'd love to see this with a subject. Maybe something as simple as someone walking through the frame. Finally, it was time for the last shot of the day. I had found these containers and decided to get a shot of these. Same as the last few photos, I like this scene, however, it misses that one subject to focus on. Don't get me wrong, a photograph doesn't need a subject, but certain compositions could really benefit from a subject, I think. This one really calls for some point of contrast to be placed in this space here. But that's the nature of photography, I guess. We can't always have everything we'd like for our photos. That was the end of the day for me, and I headed home. Overall, I'm quite satisfied with the results I got, and apart from that, the process in general was a fun experience. I hope you enjoyed tagging along. Leave your thoughts in the comments, which is your favorite of the day. Mine is this one, I think. The photos at the lake are also really cool, but I think I feel this one the strongest. Anyway, that's it for this week. If you enjoyed the video, I'd appreciate a like. It helps me and the channel to grow. Consider subscribing if you haven't yet, and I'll hopefully see you again next week in the next video. Until then, goodbye.